Welcome, I'm the Word Nerd, and in this video we are going to do a topical study for beginners. And what you're going to need is some paper. So I have this dot grid notebook paper that I got from Walmart for a couple of bucks. You'll need a pen, and you'll also need the NLT Illustrated Study Bible. So this is a topical study for beginners, and it's using the NLT Illustrated Study Bible. I have other videos kind of explaining topical studies, but this is more geared to beginners, and I love the NLT Illustrated Study Bible, and I always recommend it. And I know that people that, you know, my audience that watches, they do have this Bible, and I was like, ooh, let me, like, maybe show them something that maybe they haven't thought of doing, or, you know, if they're beginners and they're just trying to read the Bible, maybe, you know, this can help them. So this is going to be for beginners. I have other videos, like I said, that kind of goes a little bit more in depth and things like that. But I think this is amazing. Like I said, I love this. So we're going to be doing some mind mapping, I guess, which is, you know, basically connecting things together. So we're going to put faith in the middle, because that is what we're going to be doing a topical study on, is faith. What is faith? And things like that. So I'm just going to put faith in the middle, draw a circle around it. And the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to look up the definition. In the back of this Bible, you have a dictionary / concordance. And I have it marked off already, but it has the definition. Now, there are many different scriptures with the word faith, and I highly recommend reading those scriptures. We're not going to do it in this video, but I definitely think that you should. So here I realize that I want my words and boxes and stuff different thicknesses, so I'm going to use another pen for that. But you don't have to if you don't want to. I'm also going to use this like darker yellow color. I really love this color, and because I like color. You can do what you want. You do you. You know what I'm saying? All right, so the definition. So this is a noun, and they have the definition as reliance, loyalty, or complete trust in God. And then the second definition is a system of religious beliefs. So we're really focusing on the first one, reliance, loyalty, or complete trust in God. And also within this, they say also see trust and see believe. And so they are connecting those two words, believe and trust, to this word faith. And so because of that, we are going to go ahead and look up those definitions as well and add them to our page, because they are definitely connected. If you do like a more in-depth study, you'll know that the original language in the Greek or the Hebrew, especially in the Greek, faith has a connotation about trust and believing and stuff. So believe is a verb, and it's to trust in, to hold firm conviction about, to accept as true, genuine, or real. And we're just going to box off these and draw arrows to them, connecting them. And that's kind of like what mind mapping does, right? It's very similar to verse mapping. I just love this way of kind of like thinking things out. It really helps me to visually see it and visually see the connections. And then we're going to do the next word, which is trust. And there is more than one definition for trust, because it's a noun and also a verb. So noun is assurance, reliance on the character, ability, strength, or truth of someone or something. And then the verb is to place confidence or depend, to commit or place in one's care or keeping, to rely on the faithfulness or accuracy of. So as you can see, believe and trust and faith, they all really do connect in a way. So we're going to just draw another arrow to connect those, add some color. So the next thing that we are going to be doing is we're going to go to another section in the back of this Bible, which I think is really cool and unique. I don't really see it in the other study Bibles, which is the Strong's, or it's like a word study in the Hebrew and the Greek. And so we're going to look at the Greek, and to my surprise, they actually do have the Greek words that are translated as faith, which was really cool and interesting. Like, when I started this, I didn't know that they were going to have it actually, you know, in there, so I was pretty excited about it. So, Strong's number 4100 and Strong's number 4102. One's a verb, and then there's the noun that is connected to it. And then, so the verb, I can't speak Greek, so I can't pronounce it, but then we have the verb and the related noun refer to confidence that something is real, with a strong implication that action will ensue from this belief. While faith can be mundane, example, believing a report, like in 1 Corinthians 11:18, in the New Testament, it almost always refers to faith in God or faith in Christ. Such faith entails active belief, entrusting oneself completely to God. So, this faith is not just a mere, you know, belief in something. It is really completely giving yourself over to God, you know, and what you are trusting and believing in. So, that's another section, and we're going to box it off and then add a little bit of color and draw a arrow to that as well. So, after we do that, we're going to go to the section in the back of the Bible, which is, that has all the notes, right? So it's called featured indexes. And what that is it has all the different kinds of notes together in one place so you can find it. And they do have a few that is about faith, three different ones. And so we're going to go to each one and kind of read about them and then, you know, kind of summarize what we're reading. So this first one is, you know, titled By Faith. And this is like different themes. So, by faith, and this is in Hebrews 11. If you don't know Hebrews 11, please read, because that is like the faith chapter. And it really just shows that faith is more than just a belief. Faith involves confident action in response to what God has made known. To live by faith means no matter our circumstances, we live out our belief that God exists and that He is a rewarder of those who sincerely seek Him. And that's from Hebrews 11:6. Those who live by faith take confident action based on what God has revealed about His character, seeking to do His will in all things. So if you read Hebrews 11, it's over and over again, you know, that people are obeying God and confidently doing something because they believe what God has said, even though they have not seen the promise, right? Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Moses, you know, Abel, all these people, they believed God. They had faith in God that they were going to bring whatever He is telling them to pass, and they confidently did what they needed to do because they believed God. And that's what faith is, right? It's action in response to what God has already told us. The next theme is called faith and faithfulness. It's like a smaller kind of little thing, but it's really good too. It's in James 2, 14 through 26. And if you've read James, you know that James really emphasizes, has an emphasis on faithfulness to God. Right, and his argument is that this argues that charitable deeds or good deeds as an expression of faith, right? Saving faith results in action. Faith and good deeds are inseparable. As with Abraham, good deeds show that a person has complete faith and is righteous before God. James gives Abraham an example. God promised him to multiply his seed. And he was like, cool, you know, and then his faith was counted as righteousness, which we're going to get into in a minute. And so in Galatians 5:6, it says, faith expressing itself in love. What is our faith expressing itself in love, right? It's good deeds, right? Good deeds is our faith expressing itself in love. So if we're trying to express our faith, we're going to do good, and we're going to do loving things, and we're going to obey God, because if we're trusting in God, we're going to follow Him and please Him. So the last theme is faith and works. And this is actually in Matthew 25, 31 through 46. And this is about the parable of the sheep and the goats. And this parable is an example of the indissolvable link between faith and works. The connection between faith, works, and final approval is a constant feature of Jesus' teaching. For Jesus, works are an indicator of faith, which begins with repentance. Salvation is not achieved by works, but are the natural consequences of a relationship with Jesus Christ. When you have faith in Jesus, you're going to repent of your sin. You're going to turn away from your sins and turn to Jesus. And Jesus said, "Follow me. Take up your cross and follow me." And when you're following Jesus, the natural consequence of having a relationship with Jesus is going to be obeying Him, doing good works, doing good deeds, doing lovable things, right? It's action. If we say that we love Jesus, we're going to obey Him, right? Jesus said, "If you love me, then keep my commandments." So action is always the natural consequences, right? The fruit of our salvation is good works, is obedience. It's not the cause, it's the natural consequence or the fruit. And then we have some scriptures that I wanted to really talk about because I think they're important. So Ephesians 2, 8, 9 in the NLT says, "God saved you by His grace when you believed." That word "believed" is actually faith in all other translations. So you might have heard it, you know, you are saved by grace through faith, right? And you can't credit this. It is a gift of God. Salvation is not a reward for good things we have done, but is by grace, so none of us can boast about it. So we are saved by grace through faith. So through our faith, we have salvation. It is a gift of God. Salvation is a gift of God. Romans 4:5 says, "But people are counted as righteous, not because of what their work, but because of their faith in God who forgives sinners." So when you put your faith in God and when you repent, that faith is counted as righteousness. And that is how you are declared righteous before God, because you put your faith in Jesus. And then in 1 John 3:7, it says, "Dear children, don't let anyone deceive you. When people do what is right, it shows that they are righteous, even as Christ is righteous." So your faith is counted as righteousness, and you can be declared righteous by the blood of Jesus. And then your actions show that you have put your faith in Jesus, because you're going to follow Him and do what is right. This faith is a belief, a trusting, right? You're relying on God completely. And that is how, when you do that, that is how we can, no matter what our circumstances is, we still do what is right, because we have faith that God is going to reward us and provide for us and keep us, because He is good, He is faithful, He is grace, He is merciful, and He is gracious. So we want to make sure that we have a good understanding of what faith is. And I really enjoyed this topical study. If you want to purchase these notes, they will be linked in the description on my shop. And so I hope you are enjoyed. I hope you are encouraged and inspired to dig deeper into God's Word. I hope this helped you to use the NLT Illustrated Study Bible. I think it has great things in it. You can really dig deeper into the Bible with it. And so, yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Remember, God loves you, and He's always with you. Bye.